This is the third destination on my 10-day trip to Kyushu. After river rafting in Kumamoto, I went to Kagoshima. From Shinyatsushiro, it takes 45 minutes via Shinkansen to Kagoshima Chuo. Kagoshima Prefecture is known for beautiful beaches, including many small tropical islands close to Okinawa. While staying at the hotel in Kagoshima City for 3 days, I was able to go on short excursions to enjoy beautiful nature in Kagoshima Prefecture. In this episode, I will introduce you to scuba diving, fishing, and local delicacies. Daiwa Roynet Hotel Kagoshima Tenmonkan is a contemporary hotel that just opened in 2022. Situated in the heart of Kagoshima City, it was convenient to go to many places on foot, by streetcar, or by taxi. The first stop was a Kagoshima-style ramen shop, a 2 minutes walk from the hotel. This shop has been around since 1972. I like dipping cold ramen noodles into warm, thick tonkotsu soup with a lot of bonito flavor. Late in the afternoon, I went to Iso Beach, which was a 10-minute cab ride. It was a calm beach perfect for swimming for locals while looking over Sakurajima Island. Following day started super early. I booked a charter fishing trip for my husband and son. It took only a 5 minute cab ride to get to the dock. The captain from the Orque Fishing boat brought 2 assistants. My folks are seasoned fishermen, but definitely needed extra help in communicating in Japanese. I do not fish. I signed up for a scuba diving tour by myself instead. The shop owner from Aqua Trip Diving picked me up from my hotel, and we're off to Bonotsu Akime. It is on the other side of Kagoshima Prefecture, which takes an hour and a half by car or 60 kilometers from downtown. This area is famous for being the filming location for the classic James Bond movie, You Only Live Twice. The beach was calm and warm. The dive shop owner chartered a boat from a local fisherman. They fished and caught sea snails while we dove. Since I haven't scuba dived in a while, the dive master gave me a refresher course on safety and made sure I was comfortable. I saw a variety of fish and sea urchin. It was a wonderful feeling to see all the creatures up close in the water. After 2 tank dives, we ate freshly caught fish for lunch at the one and only restaurant at the port, which was filled with 007 memorabilia. This village must be very proud of being featured in the all-time popular movie. In the meantime, my husband and son had a great day fishing at the Chiringashima area. They caught many fish, including 2 big yellowtails. The fishing boat captain was gracious enough to bring these catches to a local restaurant in the afternoon. Chefs at the Bakugeki restaurant created a beautiful presentation out of the yellowtail and bonito they caught, as well as grilled snapper from their catches. This was a perfect way to end a terrific day. Next up is a day trip to Sakurajima Island, the most active volcanic island in Japan. See you then!